who said, no, I've had enough of this world system. I'm tired of this. My friends, we tell you, come to Jesus today. Why come to Jesus? Because he's worthy. Why do we come to Jesus? Because he is glory. Why do we come to Jesus? Because he is the truth. And he loves you. He loves you. You may not realize it right now. Maybe I don't realize it myself. Maybe I'm preaching to myself more than anyone else. But Jesus loves me. Jesus cares about me. Jesus sees what I go through. Jesus sees the pains of this life. He sees me when I analyze everything. He sees me when I take note of all the hostility, all the anger, all the bitterness, everything that is wrong that goes before these eyes. He knows that it's there. And he's telling me and he's telling you, I'm aware of your sufferings. I know what you're going through this day. Some more than others. Some may be rejoicing, but some may be depressed and suicidal and saying, I don't want this anymore. I don't want this life anymore. I'm tired. I'm tired of walking these streets and looking for love in my fellow man's eyes when all I see is hostility, when all I see is envy and confusion and greed and lust. I'm tired of walking these streets. I'm tired of this. I'm tired of living in this sin-infested world. I'm tired of dwelling here. I'm tired of living in a world which does not acknowledge God. I'm tired of these things. When everything I believe in, when everything I know about Jesus Christ is unbelieved by this world, knowing the truth of Jesus Christ, and when I try and tell people, I say, listen to this good news. We can be forgiven. Everything we've ever done can and will be forgiven in a second. In a second of time, we can be forgiven. And listen to me, the living God, the God who made the heavens and the earth, became man. Why? To die for you, so that you would not have to suffer. You would not have to suffer the rejection of God.
What
Jesus
why?
Said,
what reasons you got,
my
bro?
My God,
because
why have you
it's written in the Bible,
yeah.
Thou shalt not suffer a witch
why
to live
the Father
in Exodus. So therefore,
for
it's all right to kill people that are suspected
you,
of being witches.
So
that's
that
what it says in the Bible.
Do we kill witches today?
That's what it says in the Bible.
Or do we kill witches?
No, you should do that if you're following the Bible.
Did Jesus kill a witch?
Why didn't he?
He died for us.
No, he didn't. I wasn't even alive when he was born.
What do you think of John 3:16? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son.
I think that the Bible was written by man. Not God, by man.
So what do you believe?
I don't believe in God.
So are you an atheist?
Yes. But there again, if you're going on about the Bible, what about this killing witches? It's written in the Bible. If you know your stuff about the Bible, go to the page.
You'll
be there in 15 minutes.
We follow Jesus, bro.
Not the Bible.
But Jesus is the sum of the Bible.
Not the Bible.
Jesus
you
is the sum of it.
You either believe in the Bible or you don't. And if you believe in the Bible, you should be out there chopping witches. And if you don't,
you've got to understand. You've got to understand it's about Christ, sir. Christ is the centre.
Divided by the devil himself. This is why when we turn on the television, we become brainwashed. We become deceived the second we turn it on. But if you pick up the word of God, things will finally make sense. I understand why I am here on this earth. I am not here to accumulate possessions. For Jesus said these words, what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? What will you give in exchange for your soul? Your soul is eternal. Your soul will live forever. And God, Jesus, has prepared a place of many mansions. Of many mansions for those who overcome this life. But we have to overcome. We have to have faith in God. And I struggle sometimes. I struggle having faith. But I know this. God is faithful. He is faithful, and I am a failure, but he is the savior. I am weak. I am a weak man. In my own strength, I'm a coward, an absolute coward. But when I look to Jesus, he gives me strength. He gives me strength to walk these streets and tell you lovingly, Jesus loves you. Jesus Christ wants you to become his child. Right, and I know it may sound strange, and I know it may be strange to your ears, but this is the truth. When Jesus walked the shores of Galilee, he wasn't comfortable around religious elites. He wasn't comfortable about those who thought highly of themselves. He wasn't comfortable with the elites of society. Nay, the common people heard him gladly. The common people heard Jesus gladly. Why? Because they saw in him a savior who didn't condemn them for being poor. Nay, rather the opposite. Jesus said, go and tell John the things which you hear and see. The poor have the gospel preached to.